second. You guys can't see it, but the plastic has broken off here at the end. And I still can use it because of the Velcro strap, but it, you know, you pay $130 or whatever it is, I can't remember. And you know, it's just, it's not worth it sometimes. Like, you think, wow, I paid $130 and wow, the plastic just broke off. But you know, it does its job. I like the product, so that's why I bought it 4 times. But this is the 4th one, and you see it's not in good shape, but it still works. So, you know, take that into consideration. There are pros and cons to using the whale tail, but it's a really good diffuser, and if you're going to get involved in other types of photography, I definitely recommend it. Now, the 4th type is a kind of like a card. It's kind of like the white card you see in different flash units. They have a white card here, but there are other types where it's a bigger card, so it diffuses the light even more, that attach to the tip of your camera, just like this. And a good one is the 8020 by LumaQuest. So it's about like 80% of the light is bounced off the ceiling, and 20% of the light shoots onto your subject. So it's a much softer light. And you know, those cards are great. There are different options. I do like those, but sometimes I think the look is a little too artificial, or it's not as natural as having some light, or it's not as creative. Because with one of these diffusers, I can point the light at certain areas of their body, or have to shape the light better than just pointing it straight up. So it doesn't matter of preference, but those are the 4 types of diffusers that you can get. I don't really use the card anymore, so you know, the easiest example or the simplest example is a card just like this, but it's going to be much bigger. Now, which one do I recommend? If you have the money, get the whale tail, because you can use it. You can creatively use it. There's a lot of flexibility, and you can use it for other types of photography. But even if you're going to get the whale tail, get the Omnibounce. The reason why, it's durable, you can put this into your pocket, and you know, it's not going to break, and it does a great job of diffusing the light for the cost and for the size. You could always experiment with your aperture, shutter, and ISO settings to get more ambient light, and your flash exposure compensation or your flash power to soften the light. So, you know, even though you don't get a bigger diffuser, you still can work with this. So I recommend the Stofen Omnibounce and the whale tail if you have the money or you want the best nightclub photos. There are a lot of other variations, I mean, a lot of other diffusers, so other people may have different experiences. And if you have used a different diffuser and you had really good results, no, please leave your comments, suggestions, and recommendations and your feedback in the comments portion for this episode. All other viewers will want to hear from you, and I definitely want to hear from you, and we can definitely communicate because we all just want to get better. So, if you're a nightclub photographer, definitely get a flash diffuser. You have to invest in a flash diffuser, and make sure you experiment and see which one works best for you. But definitely invest in the Omnibounce. You have to. It's just really cheap, $30. So until next time, this is Myles. I want to say hello to the nightclub photographers in Chicago. In a few weeks, I'll be out there shooting with you guys and interviewing some of you guys for Nightclub Photography TV, get some tips and some tricks and strategies, things like that. So until next time, happy shooting. I'll see you guys next episode. See ya.